PK has arrived. So glad to be back in the beautiful KF Arena in the beautiful city of Nashville, Tennessee. Thank you everybody for stopping by. We got a lot of action ahead of us here tonight, so gear up, get your seatbelt on. Time to go for a wild ride. We start off KF here tonight. We game will begin with the Mitsun, the KF Tag Team Champion. continue on the night with a pretty big match to start the thing off. This week of chaos is pretty big in its own couple of ways. It's Elok versus TCT. This match was our match of the year candidates back in year 2, Hell in a Cell, in the match that they had for the Chaos Championship. That's the one where Adrian cashed in and allowed TCT to win the title. TCT has never actually beaten Elok clean since year 1 WrestleMania.
Making his way to the ring from the pits of hell. Weighing in at 197 pounds.
Their rivalry has been mostly dominated by D-Lock. I mean, the amount of times D-Lock has beaten him compared to how many times TCT has beaten him, it's not even comparable. The amount of times TCT has beaten him was like one at year one's WrestleMania, which seems like a fluke considering all the other times that that E-Lock has taken him down, you know? D-Lock has beaten him like, I don't know, 5+ times. He beat him once at the title draft. He beat him again throughout the middle of year one. He beat him again at the beginning of year two. He beat him again. Well, actually, no, that's it. It's like 4-1 or something like that, right? 4 or 5-1, and that's not a good record. And now I lead me to believe, because I don't think TPT's bad by any means, right? He can beat people like Big Joe. He can beat people like Mateo Lopez, people like Adrian Lee. Like, he can beat people, obviously. He is one of the best, but is he really as good as people claim him to be? Because lately, I haven't been believing that.
And his opponent from Dallas, Texas, weighing in at 262 pounds, TCT.
There's no doubt in my mind, and I think a lot of people's mind, that TCT is one of the best on the Chaos roster, but I think he was a little overhyped for a while. I mean, I know that sounds like an unpopular opinion, but hear me out. TCT's whole career has been nothing but, I can't describe it. He's been bad, like, not as good as people have been hyping him up to be throughout the entire year one record. His win-loss record was disgusting for the most part. Of course, it takes skill to win a Royal Rumble and to beat Elok in the first place. There's no denying that he is incredibly skilled, but ever since that moment, TCT has not impressed me. Ever since he beat Elok at year one Hell in a Cell, he has not impressed me. He got destroyed by Elok at Payback. He got absolutely demolished. It kept him out with injury for a couple months. Oh! Ow! Oh, I stubbed my toe! Ah! 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 That was my pinky toe. Oh! Oh! I'm sorry. I'm moving. Elok off the rope. Triangle dropkick! So, oh my, wait, what is he doing? Elok, oh! Sneaky guy! Teasing people! TCT looked on. Referee holding Elok back at TCT. Stared down Elok in the ring. TCT rolling back in, but Elok looking for the cave in at TCT up the rope! A big arm! Connecting with the forearm! So continuing what I said, I really don't think he's as good as people were hyping him up to be for a while. Because ever since beating Elok at year one of WrestleMania, he hasn't really done much to impress me. His win at Hell in a Cell was because of Adrian Lee. He pinned Adrian to win the title, right? He never beat Elok. Never. He hasn't beaten Elok since year one of WrestleMania. And that was the only time he's ever beat Elok, please. Or beat Elok in general, I should say. Elok from the top rope. Oh, Jesus! Wait on the knees of TCT. So that's been the case a lot of the times when it comes to TCT. And then, of course, it's the Rafael Draco situation. He has not been able to do very well against Rafael Draco. That's a fact. He's never beaten Rafael Draco. Draco has only beat him. Draco beat him at King of the Ring. Draco beat him, I believe, once right in between him, right? Before WrestleMania. He beat him at WrestleMania. He beat him after WrestleMania. He beat him again at a pay-per-view. He beat him again and again and again. And TCT has been the one getting pinned. TCT got pinned by Draco at Fastlane. TCT lost to Darius Ford recently. Last week. So, can you really think TCT is as good as he used to be, or is he in general? Have other people just gotten better and he just hasn't? I mean, there's a lot of ways you could go with it. Again, I people are probably going to camp for me. Oh, actually,
I think TCT is actually really good.
And Sally, no, shut up. I feel like this is a valid thing to say, right? Like, I think this is something a lot of people could agree with. At least the ones that I've been watching for a while. But, hey, you know what? If you disagree with me, you disagree with me. Whatever. But I'm just analyzing the facts of the matter. Oh, my God. Ela, the knee traded at a mid-tuck with a TTT pop and right back up. Didn't even fly off the top rope. Double act handle. Well, here's Elok trying to fight back against it. O'Connor roll flip over from Haley. Kicked at the top of the head. Elok deciding what he wants to do next. This could be a big opportunity for whoever we pull here tonight. And there's a very high chance that Elok from the heaven with TBT a right hand. Elok doubling him from the top. No! I was expecting a somersault dropkick, but this man did a hurricane rana, but TBT kicked right back up, and look at this. He tells him no. Oh, whoa, TBT the jawbreaker. Trying to run through for a chop, Elok avoiding it. High kick to the head, a low kick to the midsection, avoided by TBT. Up the 3-4, but the 4-4, but here's Elok looking for a cave in. Countered by TBT. Kicker into the corner, the opportunist now trying to grab him. Elok moving out of the way. Elok grabbing him. Knee strike, kick to the midsection, back elbow, kick to the midsection again, punching him down into the meteora to the head. Beautiful combination by Elok. Oh! Look at what a Phoenix Black with TPT and rolled out of the way. Not trying to capitalize. In the corner, hit the opportunist on a stunned Elok. Claymore! Elok knocked down with a claymore, but it's not enough. And of course it's not enough. It's going to take more than one claymore to put down Elok. Elok is one of those rare competitors that one finisher is not going to put him down for the 3 count. That's just how it works when it comes to Elok. We'll kick to the midsection. Here's Elok again. TPT, oh! Looking for the whiplash. Trying not to let that happen. TPT. Whoa, back the other way. Trying to go through right hand, but here's Elok. He's gonna make that shit. Look at that. Boom! He struck to the head of TTT. Struck out again. Needed to... Oh, my God. TTT again. Future Shock DDT attempt. But it's Elok flipping out of it. Damn! That might get Elok back into the thing. Don't talk millionaire of TTT, and that is an opportunity. For a former three-time Chaos Champion off the roof of speed. Telling him to bring it on, but TTT is a little too stunned, so Elok is going to improvise looking for a Frankensteiner off the rope, but TTT backs up, and now TTT back to the offense. Powerbomb position countered by Elok! Into a roll up on the sunset, flip count at 2! Nope, kick out at 2. Elok roundhouse to the head, a chop, a low kick, another chop, TPT out of the way. Kick to the midsection, a left, a knee there. TPT trying again, but Elok fighting back anyway. Bringing the arm, oh! Kick to the midsection, and now, oh, whoa! TPT again, oh! Close line him, and I'm gonna be inside out! But the top rope, now leg drop to Elok! From the heavens, and that is gonna stun this man pretty well, I'd like to assume. TPT has Elok in possession! Get out, powerbomb! And a counter by TPT! No! Elok kicked out at 2 again. It's worth an attempt over here. TPT once more! Get out, powerbomb again! No! Another kick out, 2 in a row. TPT with a burst of offense, definitely gonna help the situation. Here he goes again. Future Shock DDT, this time it connects. TPT with the upper hand over the former three-time Chaos Champion now in the corner. Telling him to get on his feet, this could end really bad. Oh, wrong way, TPT running through anyway! Oh my God! Whiplash from Elok! Cover on TTT! And he kicked out at 2! He was turned the wrong way! TTT decided to run for it anyway for a claymore in the back of the head, presumably. But Elok spinning around, whiplash! And that could be a kick out from TTT. Kind of shockingly got him up for a thin break. countered by Elok from behind. German suplex! Elok still finding ways to challenge TDT's offense, and they're geared to the side of the head. And at the very top rope, but Elok elbows in the back, but it's TDT moving out of the way. Off the run with TDT. Oh my god! Flipping him inside out again, and Elok still able to fight back anyway. Picking down TDT once more. Caught by the leg, throw TDT. Dragon screwed in a mat. Got him once more though. Look at this. Dragon sleeper. Trying to either choke out or tap out Elok, but it's not going to quite go his way. Elok still in this match with TDT getting a good amount of offense. Like I said, man. Oh my god! Whiplash out of nowhere! Are you kidding me? He's not even covering, picking him back up to his feet. Are you kidding me? Look at this guy! Dog Dog Millionaire! What the... I'm not even gonna say what I was about to say. There's no point. I just got contradicted. I was about to say TDT isn't as bad, but like this is getting real bad. Oh, Elok. Oh my god! I don't even know what to... What the hell? Oh my god. Striking away. Oh! Wind up bam across the face! Jesus Christ, man. Elok, he hit him with a whiplash. Didn't cover him. Then hit him with a Dog Dog Millionaire. What is... Oh my god. Still no cover. Handspring moonsaults in the corner. What is happening? This is reminding me of Draco. I think Elok's trying to make a point to Rafael Draco. TDT getting clobbered! Got him again. Hurricane Rana kind of took him down to the floor. This is not looking good for TDT. Here we go. Elok with momentum. People's moonsaults. A little bit of a... What you call it? What is it called? I don't know, but it was, you know, a little fluke to the rod. Shooting star from the top rope. Elok again finding his inner high flyer to make TDT pay for whatever he personally did to Elok. Take his title away at Hell in a Cell? Possibly. Elok may still be the champion, but then again, Rafael beat him at Men in the Ring, so we can really take for sure. Pele kick to the top of the head again. This is barely even a match. This is a brutalization of TDT. Ever since Draco came back, TDT has almost been getting nothing but demolished. When it comes to the end of these matches, 6:30 senton from Elok. And a whiplash again. And he's still not covering. Are you kidding me? Head first into the corner. Just gonna make section kick down again onto the floor. Elok has gone, and now TDT, oh my god. Leg drop, guillotine on the bottom. Look, this is barely even a match anymore, man. This is exactly what you don't want to see, man. This is brutal. No. Elok! Stop! Fire, Thorn, Connor, the deadliest move in PCW history! We'll get him to win! Man. It ends like that. TDT putting up a valiant effort throughout the entire match, but there it is again. Proving it clear as day. Elok is better than TDT, and he probably wouldn't have lost that title at Hell in a Cell if it wasn't for Adrian Lee. I truly do think TDT is a great superstar, but perhaps he wasn't as good as a lot of us thought he was. Elok with the win here tonight, and that is going to skyrocket him higher than he usually is. Elok still in this division, man, still looking to regain that title, but it's not going to be easy. But at least one roadblock might be out of the way. We move on with Adrian Lee. He's been changing a lot recently, as I've noticed. I don't know how to feel about it, but Adrian Lee, I guess. if all that is true, I mean, is that really the truth? Is that AJ? I never knew that. We went on the night with another big match. This week just continues to get big match after big match. It is AJ Lee with the Archangel.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making her way to the ring from Jersey City, New Jersey, AJ Lee.
AJ Lee with the Archangel. I don't know how excited I am for this match. I mean, don't get me wrong, I am excited. I want to see how this match is going to go. This is a fantastic matchup. It's going to be amazing. But I'm not excited, I mean, and the fact that I fear for AJ Lee's safety. I truly do fear for AJ Lee's safety. I mean, this is the Archangel we're talking about here, okay? I can't see AJ Lee being the Archangel. Her return was absolutely amazing, and I loved it to bits, but like, this is the Archangel, for God's sake, man. Like, come on! It's common knowledge to know that going against the Archangel is nothing but pain for the opponent. One of the best superstars to ever touch the BBW roster, male, female, it literally does not matter. Chaos, velocity. Fire, not fire.
Death Valley, Archangel.
Well, I think undoubtedly the number one superstar on the female side of BCW is going to be Kagetsu. But my God, is the Archangel like up there, man? Genuinely, like just because Kagetsu's number one does not mean that the Archangel has the potential to be number one as well. If Kagetsu was not on the roster, Archangel would be number one by miles. But I think Kagetsu is on the roster, she's not number one. But you get my point, right? It's like putting... Dude, I don't even know how to explain it to you. If you've never seen the Archangel wrestle before, and you don't know who the Archangel is, you're about to find out. I can't really say for certain that AJ Lee is going to walk out of this match to have another one. Could be her last if the Archangel truly wants to make it her last. Best tip I can give AJ Lee, if AJ Lee can hear me, maybe. Best tip I can give is to not make the Archangel mad. Just wrestle your match. And if she starts to get crazy, just take the pitfall for your own safety. Because you've seen what the Archangel will do if you make her mad enough. Christina May's career ended. Danielle's career almost ended. Because Danielle, like, did, I don't know. If you saw the drug match, you know. Sarah Ace's career ended.
Even though it was a good thing.
I mean, the Archangel is other than that, hurt so many people, so can you really say for sure that the Archangel is going to not destroy AJ Lee here tonight? Or can you say for sure that AJ Lee's safety is granted in this matchup? I don't think that's the case. But hey, I'll hope for the best. It's not like I want AJ Lee to lose. I want her to beat the Archangel's life out of her own body. But the chances of that are a lot lower than you think. But here we go. AJ Lee, the Archangel, one-on-one on Chaos. We are underway. Oh, God, no! Oh, Jesus! Starting off with the boot right there on Sage, trying to look for that leg drop. AJ's experience might be helping her out in this match, though. Jefferson thought it might have made a prediction. It's going to be the Archangel, but I think the experience of AJ Lee is going to have a great fighting chance against the Archangel. Head first into the mat. AJ now to the top rope. Look at her flying from the header. Looking to take this thing high already. Archangel, if you hear AJ Lee! Look at what a cross body. Archangel, stop that. Striking away on AJ, who's on a knee. Roll that away. AJ Lee, one and through. Hurricane Rana whip on the middle rope. AJ now, oh, needed a back. AJ now with Archangel back to her feet. AJ thinking, oh, whoa. Oh, the hand swing. A back elbow. AJ Lee to Spider Age. Athletic as could, oh, athletic as ever. It's like she's in her early, her late 20s, early 30s again. Maybe even early 20s. This is incredible. AJ Lee. With another dragon screw and now stretching the arm. AJ Lee is 35 years old. Okay, AJ Lee is not as old as I thought she was. I thought she was like in her 40s. Okay. AJ Lee is 35. Hey, that's like peak. Wait. That's like peak. Wait. Maybe AJ Lee is at her peak. Yo, maybe she can be the Archangel. I thought she was like older, bro. I didn't study too well. I really did think AJ Lee was like older than that. I thought she was like in her 40s or whatever. Kind of like a veteran coming back, but no, AJ Lee is 35. Maybe he has a chance. But again, it's the Archangel. Maybe I should be a little more careful. Trying to fight back, though. He's gonna miss that. She's taking her to the corner now. Oh God! That elbow into the corner of AJ Lee. Yeah, I mean, I truly do. I truly do want AJ Lee to win this thing, but my God, dude, I mean, what do you do in this situation? How do you fight in this situation? This is terrifying. Honestly. Oh, but AJ Lee! Ripping the hair out of the head of the Archangel. AJ's got her back up. Standing show! Wait a minute, Jesus! Almost with the standing show anyway, but... not quite as Archangel is going to counter with a power slam. Archangel going again. Oh, the head! Belly to belly! Tossing her over top and showing her who's bought. Archangel choke slam! Man. This is what you have to expect from a match like this. Sadly, but it is true. Nothing worse than watching. Oh, whoa, watching your childhood hero get destroyed. If AJ Lee is one of your childhood heroes, I personally wasn't watching when AJ Lee was around, but still, dude. Archangel on the right. As AJ Lee in position, AJ fighting back with the back elbow. Trying to grab Archangel, moving to the right hand. Sending AJ Lee back into the corner, running through, grabbing her by the head. Oh, no. What are you doing? Stop! Oh! Into the corner, no! What the hell? Right off the rope, the thing! Flag drop to finish it off! Come on, man. Oh, Jesus Christ. And here we go. The possible setup for the end of this match! No! Looking for the tombstone, but it's AJ Lee fighting out of the air! Black Widow! AJ Lee with the Black Widow! Trying as hard as possible with the Black Widow! Oh, no, Archangel, get out of it! Oh, man. Oh, whoa, look at the clothesline! With the Archangel, put that down! Stopping everything else from happening in her own way! AJ Lee trying to fight back anyway, though. And again, whoa! Jesus! Boot sending AJ flying across the ring! Oh, again, it's the Archangel, dude. This is not good. Stop! Oh! Knee treated in a match! You know how much that has to hurt? I mean, to be fair, every move probably has to hurt a lot, but oh, right hand. Another right hand. Oh, no! Over and over in that corner. AJ Lee getting manhandled! And kind of like Becky Lynch. Get it? Manhandle slam. Ha-ha! Funny joke! But there's been a time to be making jokes. Oh, God. A change of a right, a left, a thumb! He's going to make Dexter with an uppercut as well. AJ goes down. AJ trying to get back up, but it's Archangel again with a strike. I think it was AJ Lee against the ropes anyway, though. Archangel taking her off. He's diving under a clothesline attempt. Archangel running through. Good Lord! Oh, Lariat turning AJ inside out! Oh, no, 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 no. AJ, watch out! AJ, no! Left, right, powerbomb! AJ, what do you do? Elbow drop. Oh, my God. The Chamber kicking and stomping away. AJ Lee. I really did think that AJ Lee was going to stand a little bit more of a chance than this, but this is too much! Somebody throw in the towel. AJ Lee has so much more time as a wrestler, so much more potential. But this right here, this is not how you spend it. Not against the Archangel. It's too much. AJ, oh Jesus! Spine buster from the Archangel. Well, if you didn't know before, you know now. This is who the Archangel is. Wait a minute! AJ Lee with a dropkick from behind into the corner. AJ trying to fight back, pounding away on the Archangel. AJ grabbing her, standing shell on Kelly. AJ Lee could be back into a thing. This is not over. AJ striking away and into Gary to the side of the head. Archangel now in a bad way. This is AJ Lee's time to shine. I was not confident that AJ would find her way. They're not fighting back. We're looking at something for another standing show anyway. Pulled by the Archangel. And one with an elbow to the back. AJ Lee kicking and stomping away on the Archangel. Trying to keep her down. Archangel flopped her foot away. Archangel out of desperation. Choke hold down to the mat. Archangel straightening the mood across the face. Archangel shoulder claw. Now breathing down on AJ Lee. Over and over and over again, doing what she can. Watch what happens, man. This is not good until AJ Lee fights back again. This is not over. AJ! It is the carry to the side of the head! Archangel took back to her. He's looking for something big. Not going to happen. Fighting back again. It's the Archangel. AJ Lee going back the other way. Hooked down. Archangel fighting again. Trying to go the other way. It's AJ. Lee turning it back the other way. Spinning soul kick. Another spinning soul kick. The Archangel goes to fall to the mat. AJ Lee is in control. Got her up to her feet again. There's something in my eye. This is not the time. I can't see. Ow. Ow, I can't see. AJ off the rope. Cross body. Oh, my God. I can't get it out. AJ stomping away on the Archangel. I have one eye doing this, ladies and gentlemen. I feel like I'm a lot of people who have one eye. AJ Lee off the rope with speed! Classic Kennedy's my eyes good now. I'm good. I'm chilling. I'm chilling. I'm vibing. I'm chilling. AJ trying to fight back. He starts to go back the other way. Grabbing AJ right hand. Look at AJ! This is incredible! AJ has her dunk to the chest of the Archangel. Up to her feet again. It's AJ Lee kicking him in. That's him right hand. Dragging away off the rope with big clothesline. Oh, no! Archangel ripped out of the way. She accidentally hit the referee. Brass knuckle! Hey! You suck! Brass knuckle! No, no! Archangel ripped out of the way and AJ accidentally struck the referee. Archangel with AJ Lee. No! The brass knuckle and the chest down pile driver! Cover by the Archangel! One! Two! No! Cup of the Earth! Come on! How do you not say that, Riff? This is stupid! AJ Lee was doing so much better than a lot of people expected! with the arch angle with a black knuckle shot to the head.
Angel.
It's ridiculous. AJ Lee could have had that match won for all we know. We literally don't know. Archangel may have gotten off a little bit lucky, and definitely not the clean way of doing it. AJ Lee still was so strong in that matchup. She was on par with the Archangel. That's not something you see every day, man. Hey, oh my, hey, don't do this. Wow. Not even AJ. Not there. Okay, Vaughn confidently accepts. The only reason Marco beat Vaughn before was because of those low blows and three zigzags. Vaughn Jacobs looked incredibly strong and he should have won. Championship match later tonight! We continue on tonight with a table match with two unlikely competitors. It is Benjamin Murray versus Robbie Danny doing a tables match. I feel bad for Benjamin. We already know how this is gonna end. But hey, you know what? Benjamin's getting some more TV time. We gotta love that, right?
A tables match, making his way to the ring from Staten Island, New York, weighing in at 153 pounds. Benjamin Murray.
Yeah, Benjamin Murray is here on Chaos. The global champion in a table match. You can imagine how this is gonna go. Robbie Danaher, one of the most dominant performers in the mid-card of BCW. Benjamin Murray, not so much. Benjamin has never won a match in his career other than a tag team match with Hero Mullins. That's the only reason he won. By hitting an F5 and letting Benjamin pin the opponent. So yeah, that's the only reason. What can you say, right? Here comes the opponent here tonight, though. It's Robbie Danaher. Oh, sorry! I'm so sorry. No. He has won a match in this series. Sorry. King of the Ring against Adrian Lee in round one. I apologize. He's won one single match in his career.
From Columbus, Ohio, weighing in at 245 pounds, the global champion, Robert the Anarchist.
I mean,
Center.
Look at him. Robbie Kennedy. My God. Look at him. He looks so different. And if that is Robbie, though, he's got the global championship. Yeah, was it the same way last week? Maybe I probably didn't notice last week it was the same. I didn't. But look at Robbie Kennedy. What a change. What he usually looks like. New gear, new like hairstyle and everything. Wow. All right. Well, Robbie Kennedy, the global champion on Tampa. My God, does he look different. This is not usually what I expect people to look like. But man, I'm not complaining. This guy is a lot more legitimate than he was before. He has like an afro and everything. I will tell you, an afro doesn't really make you look like a champion. No offense to Carlito. I'm talking about a full-blown afro as well. Okay, actually, to be fair, Mateo had an afro. But Mateo could rock that afro. Mateo could rock that way better than Robbie would. Benjamin, oh, trying to get the offense, looking for that dropkick, but Robbie blocking. Robbie hit one for the mistake! DDT into the mat. And this is already not a hot start for Benjamin Murray. A table match. He doesn't have to pin Robbie to win, but, I mean, can Benjamin get Robbie through a table? Like, is that something you expect? Three dropkick to the mid-deck and try to take Robbie into the corner, but Danny blocks the third one, and another DDT straight down into the mat. Danny with Benjamin, jumping on the arm of Murray. Robbie grabbing him by the head. Benjamin up and down with a third one. Danny had him back to his feet. All you gotta do is put him to a table. This is the smallest guy on the men's roster, so surely that can't be too much of an issue until Benjamin pulls on him into the corner, but quickly, and Danny is fighting back. Robbie sending Benjamin to the outside of the ring. The first, dude, this match might only be like less than a minute long. The table's right there. Danny looking for possibly a power bomb, but Benjamin not gonna allow that, taking him back in the ring, probably delaying the inevitable. Benjamin at the top looks so confident, but Robbie Danny is there waiting for the right hand, and Benjamin counters from the heaven! Drop kick to Danny! From the top rope, Benjamin did get a move off, vertically sent on bomb over the midsection of Robbie. On down to the mat, Benjamin trying to get a little bit of off until the flex. He probably don't want to pick him back up to his feet. He probably want to keep him grounded, and that's exactly why. Robbie up, oh Jesus! What is that? Like I don't even know what to call that. The neck break was from Ganadu. Benjamin. Oh, Hurricane Rana fighting back. Benjamin and Elbow still trying to get a little bit of offense in. You have to respect that. Benjamin trying to work out the grind. Robbie moving out of the way. Right hand. Look at Benjamin. He's dodging. Look at Benjamin dodging. Couldn't dodge that one though. Fatal position. Benjamin slamming him down to the mat. Yeah, well, it was good while it lasted. Danadu. Oh, Jesus, man. Oh, Jesus. This is not good. I feel so mad for Benjamin. No. Oh, my God. Spike DDT. Did you hear the things Robbie was saying earlier tonight, too, about Adrian Lee? That was, you know, that's another thing that I thought about. I mean, I would love it if Benjamin won this match. Don't get me wrong. I just don't think he can. I would absolutely love it. But I don't know, man. Is it even possible at this point? Is it really? Oh, gee, not again! Come on, Robbie! Jesus Christ. Don't you stop! Oh, my God! Spike DDT again. This is stupid. You have to understand that this is not... Oh, wait, Benjamin, hold on. Fighting out of the... I was going to say, you have to understand that this is not exactly the most fair match, but... Then again, with Benjamin Murray fighting back. Trying to go through his own way in this kind of matchup. Benjamin, right-hander! Straight to the four-hitter! Benjamin Murray, but Benjamin fighting back, though. Dragon still putting Robbie down on the floor. Benjamin Murray to the outside of the ring. He's going to pick up the table. Benjamin maybe looking to go through a little bit. Oh! Big truck Robbie with the table! Yeah! Get him, Benjamin! Yeah, Robbie did look like this earlier tonight. I just must not have noticed it. Very, I didn't really notice it. But yeah, he was talking to Adrian earlier tonight. You know, it was horrible what he said. But yeah, I didn't notice that he looked different. Remember when Murray tried to, oh no! Robbie fighting back in the kick, up to the mid direction, trying to go back. Look at Benjamin Murray fighting back anyway, though. Danny's looking to put him on the table, but Danny's fighting out of it. It's a back elbow. Now Danny with a right hand, a left hand, a right hand with a back fight again. Benjamin fighting back. Somebody go to that table in a second. I feel it. Go, Benjamin. Go, Benjamin. Put him to the table. Oh, no. Danny with a no. RKO. Oh, Christ. He busted him open. Oh, man. Yep. That's something you have to expect. A valiant effort by Benjamin Murray. Look at that. Oh, his back came out. Robbie Danny's back came out. Oh. Cable went down. Robbie's back came out. What happened? How am I gonna... Robbie's back came out on a power blow that was going to put him to the table. Danny was looking for a dropkick. Benjamin, though, fighting back. Looking to go with a Danny with a dropkick. Robbie looking to improvise anyway, though. That would have been the end of the match right there. That RKO, but his back gave out, man. What a thrill. Oh, wide bone in the back of the head. Stickle down to the mat. Here we go. In the corner. Robbie Danny looking for that beautiful pump kick. Wait, Benjamin. Oh, my God. Benjamin's up. And a clothesline to Robbie Danny. Benjamin on the middle run. Come on, Benjamin. Come on, Benjamin! Game over! From the middle! No, no! Danadu! They put a middle one, super flip. Oh, no, 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 no! He had it! Robbie Danadu! Bike DDT! Come on, man! How many times are you gonna do that? He had it! He actually had it! I believe that! If that middle rope people could have connected, he probably would have been able to win the match. In the corner, bouncing him right off the turnbuckle. Robbie headed to the outside of the ring. Benjamin Murray still face down on the floor. Robbie grabbing another table. Three tables placed around the ring. Getting it up on the outside of the ring. Benjamin back up on the apron. Benjamin Murray.
Oh my God! Benjamin! He did it! Benjamin did it! He's on a rocket to the table! Benjamin Murray! He did it! Yes! Yes! Benjamin Murray just sent Robbie flying to the table! No way!
Here is
yes.
Your winner, Benjamin Murray!
The shot to bring it home! Global champion to a title! Yeah!
And remember on that night was Danielle Garcia, the United States champion and Miss Money in the Bank. Last week something very, very strange happened regarding Nancy Craven. Yeah, I mean, I want to know Anthony too. Anthony was the one that broke her nose and caused her best friend so much pain in year two. And Danny had a lot of pain in year two as well. Ruined her chance to win the championship, so why? How does this happen? How do we go from point A to point B? And why Danielle? And we move on to what can be the final match between these two, and I guess you can consider it the whole group. Yumiko Lee taking on Great B. Lewis in a one-on-one match. In a 3-on-1 handicap elimination match, and sure enough, it had a really shocking ending. I don't think anybody really expected this, because Great D. Lewis walked out with the win. She eliminated Paige Winston, she eliminated Janet George, then she eliminated Jimmy Coley, and she took the win over the Monarchy all by herself. Yumiko Lee was confident enough to challenge Great D. Lewis to a 1-on-1 match last week to finally and hopefully end this thing off. But I think Great D has already made her point clear. She has all the will in the world to make her dream come true. Whether or not her attitude may be different, kind of depends on how you look at it yourself.
And from the United Kingdom, Grace Lewis.
We saw what happened at WrestleMania. And you could say that her actions were, you know, a given, or you could say they were not right. It all depends on your perception. In my opinion, I don't know. I mean, morally, maybe not, but was I complaining about it? Not totally. It's a really controversial situation, and Gracie still has that desire to make her dream come true. As I said, he still wants to be a big champion in this company and still wants to go on a dominant reign. That's what she's always wanted, right? But it's just things are a little bit different now. She got herself involved in the Monarchy, and well, that might not be her own fault, but you get the point. Because she, I guess, she didn't really do anything to trigger the Monarchy. She almost beat Paige Manson. It was kind of the Monarchy's fault for starting this rivalry in the first place, right? But hey, you know what? The Monarchy got into this thing by themselves, and now they have to try and get out of it, but it hasn't been going well. Took down Yumiko Lee, took down all three at Fastlane, and Yumiko Lee might be going down again here tonight. The table goes down, Great Day Lewis lands a right hand on the Yumiko Lee. Striking back away, chopped and a back elbow, not quite. Yumiko trying to go back the other way, but Great Day with a kick, unhunted a midsection, and rake in the eyes of Yumiko Lee. Yumiko Lee, who's never won a championship in her career, while Great D. Lewis is a one-time Velocity Takeover Women's Champion. Chaos Women's Champion. And a Royal Rumble winner from the number one spot. Very, very good accomplishment from Great D. Lewis. And sometimes you don't need 100 of them to make yourself look really good, because Great D. Lewis always does it all by herself. Yumiko Lee caught in a bad spot. What is the plan for Great D. Lewis? Already taking control of this entire match. Yumiko Lee struggling. Looking for a strike. Yumiko kicking her back in the leg. Trying to take up some mobility from Great D. Lewis. Right hand kick back the other way. Great D. grabbing Yumiko Lee. Boom! Hard knee right to the face of Yumiko Lee. And later down with a DDT to the foot. Oh, the top now! Land the moonsault from the springboard! Great D. Lewis all of a sudden awakening whatever demon inside of her. Flying from the top rope. I know she's a little bit of a daredevil and has done it before, but my god, dude. It's always impressive. It's always, you wonder how a human can do that. But this time it's Yumiko Lee trying to go back the other way to throw a little bit of offense. Ground and pound of the former champion. Here's Great D. Lewis flying back the other way, whipping her right across the floor. Momentum carried into going across the ring and falling down onto the canvas. Leafy Lewis striking away on Yumiko in a corner. Over and over again, a violent party over there in the corner as Yumiko Lee gets dropped down again. There's an elbow from Leafy Lewis. Leafy has Yumiko Lee in position. Yumiko though trying to fight back, trying to grab her. Leafy moves out of the way, dodging through multiple times. Leafy, a drop kick right on that middle rope. That up in her wheelhouse. Over for that. Tiger feet. Kick! Yumiko moves out of the way, but there's Leafy countering with a flying forearm. Graded in a kick up, and now from the heavens, line to land a moonsault, but Yumiko Lee gets the knees up. Yumiko trying to capitalize, grabbing Leafy Lewis, and waiting a knee strike right into the head. Yumiko Lee with Leafy Lewis in position. Leafy trying to recover with a spinning heel kick to the midsection. Lewis has Yumiko Lee back to her feet. Leafy out right, Yumiko counter the right on her own. Leafy rolling out of the way, but Yumiko countering with an arm drag, putting Leafy Lewis down into the mat. Lee looking for the 8th defeat and a giant win here tonight, but Leafy Lewis certainly not going to make that easy for Yumiko Lee, if you can see so far. Funded to the midsection off the counter of the 8th defeat, but Yumiko Lee trying to go back the other way. Leafy rolled out of the way, flying for him a second time. And that's Yumiko Lee calling right there. Back on the feet, Leafy up the three, throw round out across the skull. Full momentum straight into the head of Yumiko Lee. Leafy now has Yumiko against the ropes. What is the plan for Leafy Lewis? Taking off the ropes for momentum. Yumiko, arm drag back the other way, off the ropes, arm drag. Pull off the three board. Leafy Lewis running through for a strike. Yumiko counters again, kicking the back of the leg. Right hand, and Leafy going back the other way too. Trying to kick the midsection as Yumiko back and forth. It's Leafy now going right back the other way herself. Not a combination. Lewis, double palm strike. Got him against the rope, kicked down to the floor. Here's Leafy off the rope with speed. Drop kick right across the midsection. Yumiko falls to the bottom rope with speed. Drop kick right across the head. Trying to crack up in the skull on Yumiko Lee. And now it's Leafy Lewis from the corner again. Psycho kick. Yumiko Lee rolling out of the way just in time. Trying to keep what little conscience he has to avoid any dangerous moves. Leafy Lewis has a throw at her, but Leafy fighting back out of a Yumiko Lee hold again. Kick her right to the midsection. Got her up. Northern Lights Southwest down to the mat. Cover by Leafy Lewis. 10 of 2. Yumiko getting the shoulder up. Not enough, but Leafy so far so good. Yumiko though countering back the other way. Here comes Lee, all right. Leafy moving out of the way, looking for the protection next. But it's Leafy Lewis fighting back the other way. Grabbing Yumiko into a DDT, but Yumiko powering out of it with punches right through midsection. Right hand being put to you. Yumiko up with a suplex, darling, but it's Leafy Lewis working out of it from behind, carrying the momentum into a German suplex. Yumiko Lee may only be angering Leafy Lewis. Taking her into the corner, here's Leafy. Taking Yumiko to the other, oh, whoa, cutting back into the corner off the rope with speed! Face buster into the mat! Yumiko trying to roll back, single leg dropkick rallying. Yumiko's face must be in a lot of pain though. You can imagine going face first into the mat as hard as he did right there would not be very ideal. Yumiko with a shoulder block in the corner, and a super kick in that corner number one. Off the other side, another super kick. Here comes Yumiko Lee for number three. A super kick barrage in that corner, and it's maybe Yumiko Lee's time to shine. Right hard in the back of Leafy Lewis, grabbing her by the arm again, twisting around, and manipulating the lifted arm of Leafy Lewis. Lift her over and back to her feet with Yumiko Lee's plan. What's the opening for Yumiko from behind? Looking for a Tiger Suplex. But then Leafy Lewis fighting back the other way. Lewis has Yumiko into a float over. Now Suplex. Lewis jumping down. Leafy trying to stop away on Lee. Here's Leafy Connor into a snap German. Yumiko tried to run through. Got caught. Cyclone kicked in the back. Leafy Lewis all of a sudden take control. Grabbing Yumiko and taking her away from the rope to the other side. Now it's Leafy Lewis setting up on the top rope.
could it be? The Maker! Will Yumi Cole looking for the throw job bomb? Will Yumi Cole rolling out of the way? Forearm snap direct to Lee. Yumi Cole avoiding what could have been the end of the match right there. A Quantum Bomb to take it out her whole team. Looking forward to protection. Napa, here's Gracie. Women are straight on the bottom, the middle rope again. Now, well, Gracie out there in a wheel. Rock diver, fake kick. Gracie Lewis now, what a throw. Great shot, boom. Into a face buster. Now got him back to a feet. It's time for Gracie Lewis to take this high flying possibly. Lewis has Lee against the rope. Gracie flipping Yumi Cole off the rope. Gracie with speed. Run it through. Bam! Right through the rope. Gracie Lewis finding all the momentum on her side. This is exactly why Gracie Lewis is a former Royal Rumble winner, TakeOver champion, and a women's champion. Russian leg sweep straight into the barricade. Lewis now looking to inflict as much pain as possible. Yumiko in the ring and Gracie heads to the top rope. Lewis from the heaven. Here's Gracie! Watch out, bomb! Tower on a cry and it doesn't look like Gracie covering. Gracie deciding against it? Oh my god. Gracie Lewis not even going for the cover off a Swanton Bomb. Gracie Lewis wants to show the world why she should be feared. Coangela holding a corner. One thing that Gracie Lewis has always said that losing at WrestleMania and going absolutely rogue was no one will underestimate me anymore. And I think Gracie right here is trying to prove that. I have a feeling to win it. And Fastlane was enough to do that, but Gracie Lewis clearly have not done enough to Yumi Cole in her own mind. Tiger Finn kick in the corner. Gracie now headed at a top rope. They're gonna fly forearm across the skull. Gracie Lewis with Yumi Cole on the floor. Cyclone kick to the back again. Gracie on the middle rope now. Staring down at Lee. Bounced off from the top. She popped right up into it. And now, Gracie, right back to the heaven. Calder and game over from the top. Quantum Bomb! Cover by Gracie Lewis and the victory. The skill gap grows even larger. I don't think there's any mistaking it now. Gracie Lewis with a dominant victory over Yumi Cole. I think that's going to put that to rest. Yumi Cole had a good attempt, but once Gracie Lewis got rolling, it was no stopping her. Lewis with the win, and once again proven to the world that the monarchy stands no chance against someone like Gracie Lewis. But to be fair, there really is no one else like Gracie Lewis.
Here is your winner, Grace Lewis.
The one is next in the career of Gracie Lewis. A win against Yumi Cole and the monarchy, taking them all down all by herself. I'm surely wanting to go to much higher places like she used to be in year one and two, so. Question is, how did she get there? What is next in the mind of Gracie Lewis? And as we move on, our next match on the night card is Amber Rae versus Nyla Tempa.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making her way to the ring from London, England. One half of the Women's Tag Team Champions, Amber Rae.
Amber Rae is here tonight to take on Nyla Tempa. Amber Rae, obviously one half of the tag team champions, and Nyla Tempa one half of the Seven Saints, and we really haven't been doing too well. The Seven Saints, I mean, Nyla's been doing pretty good, but Ayla has not. But Nyla Tempa going against one half of the tag team champions, looking to get some redemption for the Seven Saints. So, Nyla is very good as a singles competitor. Maybe she ought to just become a singles competitor, because clearly Ayla is holding her back, right? But hey, you know what? This is a big chance for Nyla Tempa to go against one half of the tag team champion. Nyla, who's never won a title in her career with Ayla.
From the pits of hell.
Here comes Nyla. One of the better tag team superstars in PCW. Mostly doing stuff on her own. I mean, it's not to say Ayla doesn't do anything, but Nyla Tempa is clearly the MVP of the team and one of the MVPs of the entire division, honestly. Nyla Tempa, though, looking to pick a winner, but one half of the tag team champion looking to fly a little bit higher than she did before. Nyla had a chance to do it because Nyla's taken down plenty of superstars before in the tag team division all by herself, so maybe she can do it against Ember Ray as well. Right? You never know. She's taking out Sophie Bryant, so that's a start. Sophie Bryant's already very good in the role, right? While it was by roll-up, a win's a win, right? But Ayla, obviously not here tonight by Nyla Tempa, and MJ Taylor, not here tonight by Ember Ray. It is just a simple one-on-one match, one half of the tag champ versus Nyla Tempa. Who's gonna get the win? We're about to find out. Ember Ray starting off the offense with Nyla Tempa blocking and carrying back her own way. Nyla has a very unique style of wrestling. While it is mostly directed towards a powerhouse style, it could be pretty effective, right? Seems to be effective right now until Ember Ray goes back the other way. Suplex into the corner! Ember Ray, who used to wrestle in... Oh my Jesus Christ! No way to do it. Ember Ray, who used to wrestle in Ring of Honor for 3 years alongside her best friend, MJ Taylor. They won tag team titles around the world, even in PCW's developmental system. 467-day reign down there before losing it to 13XD and coming up to Chaos here. Of course, challenging the Epitome of Darkness for the championship and beating them, which was one of the best moments of year two WrestleMania for sure. But Ember Ray right now dominating until Nyla Tempa rolls out of the way of another vertical leap senton. Nyla Tempa got her up, but a fireman carry position with an air raid crash down into the mat. Or Death Valley Driver, I should probably say. Whichever one it is, man, I don't know. They look the same. Ember moving out of the way of a foot, leg, and leg drop, though. Here's Nyla Tempa countering off Ayla, grabbing. Excuse me, Ember Ray. Have I been saying Ayla? I need Ember Ray. I don't know. They're going to start with A, right? Ayla, Ember. It's kind of close. Look, okay, I'm not perfect, all right? I make mistakes, all right? Y'all are probably making fun of me. Shut up. Not the point. Ember Ray pounding away at the face of Nyla Tempa, not going back to the offense. Hard kick in the spine of Nyla Tempa. Amber's striking ability is like none other in this tag team division. Even above the Dodgers and her partner, MJT. Oh, God! She's a pure striker at heart, and you can clearly see it. But a move from Nyla, and she kicked away. That's on it. I'm back from Ember Ray, getting back on the offense. Ember twisting the arm. Oh, kicking with the midsection into a vertical leap again. And another vertical leap by Ember Ray. Ember, some dominant offense over Nyla Tempa right now. Very good in a one-on-one competition. Look at Ember Ray go. Ember off the ropes with speed. That turned in a back. Did you see that? Ember Ray off the ropes. Looking for a penalty kick to the face. Not going to happen. It's Nyla Tempa moving out of the way. Ember a right. Ember another one of the kick and a right hand again. Ember Ray trying to grab her on right hand of her own. Amber looking for another one. Nyla Tempa dodges. Amber dodges. Nyla grabs her off the attempt to get again. No fire with Carrie Powerbomb. Grab an attempt for Nyla Tempa to take a victory. Amber Ray breaking out of that pin. Have I been saying Ayla? You know what? I don't know. I don't care. Shut up. Maybe I haven't and I just sound like I'm schizophrenic. I don't know. Is this the right term? Shut up. Nyla Tempa putting Ember Ray back on her feet. I said Ember. I definitely did. Nyla with Ember Ray against the ropes. Oh, God, Ember taking her over the top rope. And now Ember flying. Denton bomb to the outside of the ring. Right off the springboard. While Ember is a striker, she's not afraid to take rip. That's one of the main things that her newly, well, I guess her bio that's come out recently on the PCW server. Come join. But look at Ember from the heaven. Flying with a top rope again. With another senton to the outside. Looking like the MVP of the Punk Rock 1. Brushing that off like it was nothing. Nyla back to her feet here. Ember Ray kicking Nyla back into the ring. Amber, a great performance so far. Amber grabbing Nyla, kicking her into the corner. Tempa struggling right now. Amber trying to kick her down, but Tempa trying to get her own offense back the other way. Amber going back, right hand, kick down. Low with a left elbow, but it's Nyla with the knee strike into the corner. Tempa slamming her head first right into the top turnbuckle. Tempa kick down to the floor. Kick number one, dump it out. Amber Ray in the corner. Tempa with some powerful offense down there. From behind, Nyla, no! Dumping the knee straight into the floor! Talk about some brutality! Looking for Tempa shot, back the other way, and Amber Ray striking away. Taking her in the corner, here's Amber. Boom! Kicked down to the floor, Amber Ray, with speed running through! Inverted senton! Straight down into the corner, flipping through, and now it's Amber Ray's time to shine! Amber maybe looking for that beautiful stun ray. Right hand from behind. No, she's not! It's instead the stun lock! The modified arm bar that was being talked about in the recent bio of Amber Ray. The stun lock is in. Nyla is in deep trouble, but Tempa escaping it just in time. She lasted much longer there. She might have had to tap out. She might not have had a chance to get to the ropes or anything, but Tempa tried to go back the other way with the Rona Metal offense. Kick in the face of Amber Ray. Amber still stands still, but Nyla will kick Amber again. But Amber still not falling. But a crossbody will do the job. Nyla Tempa now getting her own fair share of offense. Headed to the top rope. Here's Tempa looking to fly. Mother heaven. Body blast to one half of the tag team champion. Amber Ray and MJ Taylor, who are five-time rising star tag team champion, down there, developmental, proving her worth on the main roster. But a double back rotation suplex from Nyla Temple will try to put all that to waste. Nyla Temple with an opportunity now. Amber back to her feet. This could look really bad for Amber Ray. Kicked it up. No, look at the kicker in the midsection. Over here, Amber Ray fighting back up a chance to go for the whoa. The Temple shot. Nyla fighting back again, grabbing Amber. Amber ducks down into a kneeling jawbreaker. Right hand at the knee from Nyla to counter. Tempa slapping Amber with the flying pin. Chopper right, counter with the knee by Nyla. Right hand from Nyla, another one. Tempa trying to win the striking game. Kick in the face of Amber, still not falling. Tempa capitalizing and grabbing Amber again, putting her against the rope. Nyla Tempa, look at her down. Oh my God, touching the ankle in the rope. Amber Ray struggling down on the floor, split lady the leg drop. Amber moved again. Amber Ray up on her feet to right, but it's Nyla with a harder right to the midsection looking for a clothesline. Dive dead in the way. Thunder Ray! Amber Ray connects with a Thunder Ray! The cover on Nyla Tempa for the victory! Amber Ray with the win! Competition, but Nyla could not duck that one. Amber Ray with the victory, and Nyla Tempa actually suffered a loss. She was always telling Ayla to do a little bit better, how she kept losing and all that good stuff. But well, no, this time it was Nyla Tempa who took the loss. Amber Ray proved her worth in singles competition here tonight, and Amber Ray showed very strong. That striking game really comes out on top, doesn't it? Nyla Tempa with a top loss here tonight, and this is the first time she's actually really lost in singles competition. And of course, that Nyla Tempa isn't as perfect as people thought she was when it comes to singles matches. A loss to Amber Ray will... Uh-oh. tension continued to ride between the two. You're supposed to be a team, you two. Come on. And we move on here tonight with the Universal Champion, Paul Mysterion. With a win at Fastlane over Draven Tyrell. He's very, very high on the world right now. Uh-oh, things are about to get interesting. Paul does not want another match with Echo, but Echo has something to say about that. I can understand where Paul's coming from, but I also can understand where Echo's coming from, man. It's a very two-sided situation, and neither of them is really wrong. Hey, all right. Whoa. This is about to get even better. The tension continued to rise in Thunderbolt Kai. If you know the history between Kai and Echo, you had to be there to see it in year one. It was undeniably one of the most historical moments in PCW history. we continue on tonight with the debut match for one of the newest members to the PCW roster. It is Doc Moore taking on Jeff Maverick.
It's scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from wherever he wants.
Oh.
Weighing in at 223 pounds, Lady Destroyer.
What? Lady Destroyer. Okay, sure. Whoa, Doc Moore hit on ice to take on Jack Maverick. So Moore made his debut at Fastlane, kind of out of nowhere. I didn't even recognize the guy. But apparently he was in PCW developmental system, not even for that long. Only about half a year he spent in developmental, and apparently he was good enough to be brought up. The higher up thought so, but... Well, I mean, going against Jack Maverick is a really big test for your debut. I mean, Jack Maverick is no walk in the park. He's one of the best that roster has to offer, and Doc Moore is really putting himself to the challenge. Here comes Jack Maverick. Former Universal Champion, former Diamond Tag Team Champion. The guy has done a
from
lot.
From Buffalo, New York, weighing in at 265 pounds, Jack Maverick.
Yeah, Doc Moore made his debut of Fastlane, attacking Jack Maverick in his return to challenge Paul Mysterious for the title again. I'm kind of glad Doc Moore made his debut, because while Jack and Paul has always been super good, I always loved those matches. It was like the third or fourth time we would have seen it, right? Like, rivalry-wise. So, being it again isn't exactly the main thing that I want. But hey, you know what? Doc Moore allowed that not to happen. He is going to be taking on Jack Maverick and set a roadblock for this man right here, Jack Maverick. And the chance that in this world, there can only be one winner. And there's a chance for Doc Moore to be that winner, even if it only is his debut. Apparently, this guy has been good enough to bring up, so you have to wonder how many more times he can withstand Jack Maverick. Because last week, Jack Maverick almost dumped him into oblivion, but, well, Doc Moore did not let that happen. He uppercut him out of midair off a pop-up, and that really set the tone for how this thing's about to be. It's going to be fast-paced, it's going to be technical, and it's going to be a lot of striking. Doc Moore's debut match. What can this guy do in the ring against somebody like Jack Maverick? Maverick is one of the most competitive and one of the most credible superstars this entire roster has to offer. One of the best in the business, and truly a guy that you do not want to go against. Anybody who beats Jack Maverick is instantly a credible threat to any champion in this business. The Maverick starting off with the offense, throwing Doc Moore across the ring, now headed. Oh, he's looking to go to the top rope, but he decided against it. Maverick looking to come. Oh, God! Here's Doc Moore to counter. Went right across the face in that corner. Doc Moore looking for his old fair share of offense in a debut match. He has to impress people. For it to be his debut, he has to prove to everybody that he has what it takes. Even if he doesn't beat Jack tonight, he needs to put up a fight. It does not matter. Jack Maverick is one of the best on the roster, and he pulled out a moonsault! Doc Moore with a moonsault, but this guy has a little bit of athleticism to him, I see. Oh, up and down. Oh my goodness, he can carry him too. He's not even that tall. Oh God, looking to kick him on the face, but Jack Maverick moves out of the way, blocking. Big kick to the face. Here's Maverick with the right hand, and Doc Moore going back with the knee strike. He's gonna make action. Doc Moore grabbing Maverick. Look at the power of this guy. Jason, fall away the Samoan drop. You kidding me? Jack Maverick is like 6'2", 3, probably weighs near 300 pounds, and this guy is just lifting him up. He's not even that tall. He's gotta be like 5'8" to 5'10". Probably not even 200 pounds. So, and this guy can just lift up Jack Maverick like that. That's not usual, I'll tell you that. Oh, Jesus, Maverick with the knee to the midsection, but Maverick looking to go for his own fair share. Suplex up and down! Powering Doc Moore down to the mat, and here's Maverick from the very, very top rope. Maverick! Knee drop with Doc Moore avoiding it. Up to him with speed! One elbow to the back of the head. Doc Moore grabbing Maverick! Oh, Jesus! Knee right to the head. Maverick, look at Doc Moore. Look at the combination. Boom! Rocking up with a clothesline. Now Doc Moore up the middle rope. Connecting with the leg drop right down to the roof deck. Maverick mounts him again! What is this guy? This guy can lift Maverick. He can do moonsaults. This guy can, like, What is the style of wrestling? Look at all around fighter. Here's the strength again. Look at his combination, dude. What a start to the debut. Running through a shoulder block. Maverick trying to stop him from going any further. Doc Moore connects with another shoulder block. Maverick to the front. Maverick trying to make him pay. Looking him up with a fireman carrying position. Now dropping him right on the top turnbuckle. Moore paying dearly. But he is fighting back still. Doc Moore running. Oh my God! Chipping him right in the skull. The one chip to the head. Wow. Well, Maverick planted hard. I mean, that's not a good thing to take. Oh, Jesus. It's not a nice thing to take, I'll tell you that much. Boom. Turning him around into a knee strike. His sophomore still going strong, but it's Maverick fighting back anyway. Maverick trying to grab him, but sophomore with a back elbow anyway. Not over quite yet. Sophomore taking him into the corner. Oh, looking for a dropkick of some sort. No, he can't though. It's Maverick. You're a doggy! Straight into the knee and Irish skirt! And this guy ain't even from Ireland. He's not allowed to do that, right? Right? I don't know. Maverick. Oh, looking for a knee drop. We're not going to do it. Going again. Trying to strike him more. But, dude, this is Jack Maverick's wheelhouse, man. This guy, I don't know if he can beat him when it comes to striking. Putting it down again. That power is huge. What do you do against that? Trying to go again, not quite. Maverick fighting back, his sophomore fighting back in his own way. Maverick going back the other way as well. Sophomore dodging, Crowboy blocked down and planted to the floor. Sophomore finishers. The yep. Something like that. And the crucifixion. Very, very interesting move there. Oh my God! Very interesting, but welcoming. I mean, his moves are really nice so far. Looking for the Gary drop kick though. Gonna stop him right there. Stop him right in his. Oh, right in his back. Look at this. Sophomore still trying to fight back. Trying to grab Maverick. A kick. Sophomore running through. Whoa! Rolling neckbreaker into the floor. It's gonna land Sophomore with the kick to the back. Gone. Oh! Look at that. Landing down the fifth drop. Twice in a row and ahead of Maverick, and once again, straight down to the floor. Oh, hard knee to the floor here. Look at it, sophomore dominating Jack Maverick at the moment. Is this real? Can't be right. Sophomore grabbing Maverick. Oh God, what is this? What, airplane spin? Oh, into a TKO. What? Wow. Okay. Okay, I guess that is it. It's moved that, isn't it? Doc Moore with an opportunity. There's no way he's going to do this, right? Not now. Surely not. Doc Moore. Look at who's on top of it. Oh, my God. Counted into a set-up powerbomb. Doc Moore almost ended this match right there, but Jack Maverick had other plans. Jumping out Doc Moore on the floor. What a fury of offense, if you will, from sophomore, but Jack Maverick clearly not allowing any of that to happen. Pounding away on the face! Jesus Christ! Whatever the case is, here's Maverick again grabbing sophomore, taking him into the corner. Jack Maverick a knee right into the chin. But he's not done looking for a knee to the back, and he connects. Sophomore goes down. Maverick now ground him down on sophomore! Sophomore, because he wasn't in developmental for a very long time, has never won a championship. But yeah, like I said again, he hasn't pressed the higher up somehow to bring him up to KO so early in his career. He's not even skipping, completely skipping velocity as well. I mean, that's a pretty big step. You have to really impress somebody to do that. But here's Jack Maverick with sophomore in possession. Jesus. In what an Alabama slam. Looking for an Alabama Maverick. Here's sophomore trying to fight the clothesline. Rocking the head of Jack Maverick. Sophomore giving the former Universal Champion a fight. Dumping out Maverick down on the floor. No help for Jack. There's Doc Clothesline on the top rope. Maverick goes flying down to the mat. Oh, God. You're not. No, don't think. Oh, my God. Barrel out on the top rope. Taking down Maverick on the outside of the ring. Jesus. Sophomore can fly across the ring like... like it's nothing, and he can also lift him. I mean, this guy seems like he can do it all. With a high flyer, he has a little bit of technician and powerhouse in him, and he's a very good striker. Maverick trying to run through the sophomore, driving him right down on his knee. This is an incredible first performance. Maverick trying to fight back, chop, sophomore going back the other way with the right hand. The one chip again, right across the head. Sophomore fired up. This is his opportunity. There's absolutely no way, right? There's absolutely no way. Sophomore going up. Oh, looking with Sophomore. There's Maverick fighting back. He's got Sophomore up on his shoulders. Victory! Jack Maverick. All of a sudden turning the tables into his own. I guess his own winner of the day. The domination. Maverick grabbing Sophomore, taking him into the corner, and he might have only angered the former Universal Champion. Maverick, the right hand on the very, very top rope, looking for something big from the heaven. Jack Maverick, powerbomb from the top rope! Flying from the heaven and showing the crowd who's boss! And this might be really, really bad for Sophomore. I will say it's been a valiant effort, but I don't think this is gonna go much longer! Fall away, slam into the corner! Jack Maverick pounding away on the face of Sophomore over and over again, trying to bust him open possibly. Here he goes again. More striking to the skull, he's dead! He busts him completely open! Jack Maverick mimicking and taunting Sophomore. That's something I totally didn't miss with Jack Maverick overconfident, stomping out Sophomore over and over again. Jesus, man. Maverick, no. Maverick looking for the jump of mouth. Sophomore with the uppercut out of mid-air. Completely out of nowhere. This is what I'm talking about. Stop. He could have done the stop. No shot. Four in the cover on Jack Maverick for the win. No. Jack Maverick throwing that shoulder up at the last possible second. Sophomore. Uppercut out of midair into the stop. You thought that was it, but Maverick, oh, ducking under a roundhouse right hand. Sophomore back the other way. Maverick cattles to the strike to the midsection. Hard knee. And Sophomore falling down to the mat. Maverick has more where he wants them back into the corner. Maverick a right. Knee. Knee again. Just pounding away in the corner and talking trash. Sophomore may only be angering Jack Maverick, but if he hits another one of those, I think this match might be over. Oh God, Maverick again though. Maybe it might have been over, but Jack Maverick might end this thing first! And take it up now! Yep. Jack Maverick just beat up the whole. Oh my God! Rocket him right across the head! Maverick! Boom! And then a backbreaker, a second backbreaker, going again! Repeatedly targeting the back of this newcomer, Sophomore, who's only angered Jack Maverick more and more. This is his debut, no pun intended. Sophomore, though, moving out of the way of a strike, now more, striking with the goal. Trying to go back on Jack Maverick, fireman, Gary, this guy's so strong! But Jack Maverick not allowing Sophomore to do anything. Oh my God, no, Maverick! Man, the only thing I can say is that effort will not go forgotten. I mean, for God's sake, Jack Maverick, a former Universal Champion, one of the most dominant Universal Champions of all time, one of the dominant tag team champions of all time, and Sophomore gave him one of the biggest fights of his career. With nothing to be upset about, but Jack Maverick may have got what he wanted. Where does Sophomore go from here? What an attempt regardless. And to continue on the night, it's a very, very interesting match. It's the fourth time the stipulation has been introduced. It is a windmill match between Kagetsu, Nancy Quable, and the Chaos Women's Champion, June Quable.
The following contest is a triple threat match, making her way to the ring from Osaka, Japan.
Well, a windmill match. You may not know what the stipulation is, and I am about to explain. So, three competitors. And a time limit, most likely 15-minute time limit, right? The person who has the 1 point at the end of the match will win. So basically, it's like hot potato, but in reverse. You want the point. You want to have that point. Let's say Kagetsu pins Nancy Quable. Kagetsu will get the point. Well, let's say June Quable pins Nancy Quable next. June will get the point. But then Nancy pins Kagetsu, then it goes to Nancy Quable. Or Kagetsu pins Nancy right back, and now Kagetsu has the point. It's basically, whoever gets the pin will get the point. And it can flip back and forth and back and forth. That is why it's called a windmill match. Hopefully that, it's a decent explanation. If not, then, we're gonna get to find out how this match works. It's like reverse hot potato. That's the best way I can say it. Like, tag, you're it, but you want to be tagged. Who's against it, right? Here comes Nancy Quable, former Chaos Women's Champion Nancy Quable, obviously. I would say everybody has a chance, but I don't want to say obviously to that point. Everybody has a chance, because they don't have the tendency to get to the win. That's the only thing I'm saying, but yeah, here comes Nancy Quable.
And her opponent, first, from Alexandria, Virginia, Nancy
Quable, Kagetsu, and June Quable. Exactly, as a matter of fact, it was June and Kagetsu for the Chaos Women's Championship. June Quable was, may have been about to lose. Kagetsu hit a nasty addition drop on June Quable and looked like she was about to win the title. But Nancy Quable came out and tried to disqualify the match. Nancy Quable's not playing any sides, by the way. She's not on June Quable's side. She is an even woman. I mean, she turned on her sister a while back. You may know that. And yeah, if anyone came, Nancy Quable came in to try and end the match, because obviously she doesn't want to beat Kagetsu for the title. She probably wants to beat June for the title, because she knows she has more of a chance to do that. But yeah, it didn't quite happen. Kagetsu speared Nancy in half, then rocked her with an Abyssi Drop. That gave June enough time to recover, roll Kagetsu up, and barely escape with the championship. But the time will hopefully come soon. June Quable coming down to the ring. The Chaos Women's Champion won it at Hell in a Cell last year. And defended it in the main event of night one at WrestleMania in year two. Two-time Chaos Women's Champion on our hands and a former Money in the Bank winner. Sorry, Nancy is also a former Money in the Bank winner. Both of the Quable twins are. That's interesting, right?
And from Alexandria, Virginia, the Women's Champion,
June Quable, trying to take the win here tonight, and I guess have no doubt going into TLC about who's going to have the championship. But obviously, this could be considered a contenders match. The winner of this match will get to face June Quable. What happens if June Quable wins? Well, we do have an extra week after the Chaos Week 9, but I mean, at least for tonight, who knows, right? Well, we're hoping it's Kagetsu, obviously. I think everybody's kind of hoping it's Kagetsu. I mean, Kagetsu is... Kagetsu, come on. She's awesome. Kagetsu became the second ever person to pin the Archangel and the fourth person to ever pin Madison Ivy. Clean. Like, totally clean. I think, right? That's true, right? Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's true. I'm pretty sure that's true. I'm pretty sure about that. She pinned Kagetsu, or she pinned Madison Ivy on Chaos Week 23? I think it was 23. 22 or 23. It's one of the two. Actually, I think it was 23, wasn't it? Whatever week it was. It was amazing. Well, here we go. Oh, my Jesus Christ! Kagetsu flying through the floor for 15 minutes. The one with the point at the end of the match, the end of the 15-minute mark, will win. Nancy Quable planting her down with an inverted DDT. A reverse DDT taken down into the mat. Drop kick to the back of Kagetsu. Trying to keep the biggest threat of this match down. But now it's the fifth colliding. June Quable with a springboard. Cross body, Nancy Quable. He's out of the way! He runs straight into a knee from Kagetsu. Up the springboard, Kagetsu with a leg drop to Nancy Quable. Get that wedding through. Oh, thrashing the Faith of Jude cradle. Aggression from Kagetsu, looking for a form, but Kagetsu not able to cut that tiger suplex from Jude cradle. Or dragon suplex. What is the difference again? Dragon suplex, tiger suplex. What's the dragon suplex? It looked, I don't know. It's close enough, right? Basically, it looks the same. It's very similar. Nancy Cradle grabbing June in the front face lock. June getting out of it with elbows. Kagetsu was waiting. Samoa drop to June Cradle. Nancy Cradle now with June in position. High kick. Going again. Grabbing June. Taking her. Trying to get her against the rope, but it's not going to happen. June Cradle working out of it. Kagetsu. Circling around looking for what she wants to do next here. Cradle. But now Suplex, now here comes Kagetsu looking for a chokehold. Nancy Cradle rolling out of the ring. June Cradle now on the offense. Two elbows to the head. Connecting with a big third elbow to Kagetsu. June Cradle now knee drop right to the arm of Kagetsu. Now drop to the midsection. Double knees putting down the bride of Lord Ice, the Prime Minister Kagetsu. The final mark of BTW, if you will. It needs a title to really make that come out strong. Although, you know, she should have a title. Kagetsu should be the Galactic Champion right now, but, you know, and the Women's Champion. But, I'm not going to get into all that again. That's a long story that'll probably turn into a rant. June Cradle put down off the top rope. Now Kagetsu striking away. Kick to the midsection. And a betting kick right to the head. And the head's off there! Cutting Nancy Cradle in half just like she did at Fastlane. Nancy Cradle got caught off guard and now Kagetsu maybe looking for the victory drop, but Nancy Cradle trying to go back the other way. Kagetsu not going to allow that to happen though. Kagetsu grabbing Nancy, taking her into the corner. Kagetsu trying to strike him, but Nancy moves out of the way. Kagetsu choke her. Nancy diving out of the way from behind. Cradle got her up. Inverted suplex to the mat, and Kagetsu gets planted down. Now it's June and Nancy back at it. Nancy Cradle, another light suplex down to the mat. Kagetsu back up, so watch it. She's ever fighting back with an elbow. Kagetsu from behind, thrashing Nancy Cradle, just like she did to June. June watching all from behind. Whoa, flying for a takedown Nancy. But here, June, watch it. Little black camera to Nancy Cradle. June Cradle with the flag. Boom, a foot DDT. Now Kagetsu running through. Single leg drop to take down June Cradle. Whoa, June Cradle tripping her up, but now going after Nancy Cradle with a clothesline pulling through. Cradle getting the front on that, striking away is Kagetsu, but now Nancy hurting her type to Kagetsu on the way. Cradle still black down to the mat. Good slam. Now look at it. Nancy going right back up to June Cradle. June Cradle countering right hand. Shoot another right. Shoot a kick. Shoot a low kick. Nancy fighting back. Nancy Cradle after it. Going again. Round after the goal. Nancy Cradle keeps Kagetsu. Kagetsu stopping her in the track though. Tripping her up with a double foot dunk to the midsection. Nancy pops up though. Knee from behind to take out Kagetsu. Grabbing her again. Here's Nancy Cradle again with German. Kagetsu goes down hard. Now it's Nancy Cradle. Time to shine off the ropes with speed. Looking for something to be. Maybe some sort of dropkick with Kagetsu swatting that away. But here we go again. Nancy! Boom! One round out of the room. Watch out from behind. It's June Cradle out of nowhere. Cradle trying to trip Nancy Cradle over. Nancy! Challenges the blue to cut the feet. Diving the chop block. And a leg drop to June. Oh, wow. Falling dropkick kicked out Kagetsu, who was just getting back up to her feet, too. Nancy's got June up. Nancy trying to roundhouse Kagetsu. Kagetsu, though, wall dodging a clothesline. Got her up. Ready? Go! Slam! Now see June Cradle dropkick from behind. Take out the Chaos Women's Champion, who she should have beaten and which she would have beaten if it wasn't for Nancy Cradle. Kagetsu taking her into the corner with aggression. Now it's June. Oh, she's hanging on breaker! One of the very, very creative moves from Kagetsu. On the springboard now, Kagetsu with the springboard knee drop, take down June! Phenomenal work now, Kagetsu off the rope with speed! Flying through, but no, Nancy Cradle moves out of the way just in time! Not allowing Kagetsu to hit a nasty suicide dive, barely avoiding what could have been a harsh end to that. Kagetsu, all three women on the outside of the ring now. June and Nancy striking away on each other. Oh, Nancy Cradle! Feel the glow! Locking it in on the outside of the ring. But if you do it on the outside, it's not going to count. The Kagetsu is going to let this happen. If he taps out, it will not count. But she will not. But no, Kagetsu looking for a steel kick strike from behind on Nancy. Weapons are illegal in this matchup. Forgot to mention, it is no disqualification. Nancy Cradle did out powerbomb to Kagetsu. But now two, that's a chair from behind on the Nancy Cradle. Chair shot to Nancy, but here's Kagetsu getting caught with the chair shot of her own. That's June! A winner gets the gear to take out. Kagetsu putting her against the barricade. June Cradle now has Kagetsu off of where she wants her up and down. A snake eye glider into the barricade. June Cradle has Nancy where she wants her. Grabbing her, slamming her head first down to the metal. Here's Kagetsu trying to strike away on June. Slamming her right into the barricade of herself. Nancy Cradle getting back to her feet. Right hand from Kagetsu against the barricade, grabbing June. Women go straight into the barricade, but hit Nancy from behind. The Kagetsu, oh! The Ruth DDT straight onto the steel chair! Nancy Cradle bringing out quite a bit of aggression right there, but oh, Kagetsu going right back up with a quick popsicle kick running through. Now rolling back in the ring as Nancy follows. Kagetsu, oh! Single leg drop kick blocked by Nancy Cradle. Nancy caught with a kick and a chop. Punching away at Kagetsu striking. Beautiful combination over and over again. Into a roundhouse. Boom! Now going after. Bam! Bear to June Cradle out of nowhere. And now Kagetsu a second time. But June Cradle looking for the Kagetsu drop. But Cradle able to avoid it. 7 minutes and 45 seconds remain. Nobody has taken a pinfall yet. It is 0-0-0. Again, I'm going to start around there, man. But you get the point! Kagetsu drop! Connect on the June! Count a one! Count a two! 1 point for Kagetsu! It is 1-0! Kagetsu has the windmill right now. But if one of these others hit each other, it will go to them. Kagetsu has the point at the moment, but, again. Oh, I will make it right here! Blue Thunder Bomb! Cover! Count a two! Kagetsu breaking it up just in time! Stopping that pinfall from happening. It could have been June's point to take. Kagetsu at the point at the moment, but it may not last much longer. June Cradle with aggression, the clinch kick! Cradle now has Nancy where she wants it, looking for the Kamadoye. But it's Nancy Cradle. Oh! Letting it be very blocked by Nancy though. Nancy the right hand side to wait 6 minutes and 10 seconds when he gets the jury. From June Cradle. Now, oh, Kagetsu out of nowhere. The Moen drop position. Boom! Flat jack and then a mat. Now it's Nancy Cradle and Kagetsu striking away on June Cradle. Kagetsu going after Nancy, striking away. Nancy stuck far. Cradle caught. No, back the other way. Nancy. Glad that Kagetsu taking her to the outside of the ring. Now to behind. June Cradle out of nowhere. Cradle! Blue Thunder Bomb! Cover by June 1-2! June Cradle takes a point! Now it's 1-0 June! Yeah, that's exactly how these kind of matchups go. I mean, it's the first time we're seeing it, so you really gotta... Oh, moving pop strike from Nancy with Kagetsu out of nowhere with a steel chair. Nancy trying to sneak a cover. How stupid are you? What do you expect? Nancy taking away on Kagetsu, though, a drop kick. Kagetsu gets planted down to the floor. Straight for a moonsault. Nancy planting Kagetsu. Cover on Kagetsu. Kick out by Kagetsu. Nancy Cradle trying to grab her again, but Kagetsu fighting out of it. 5 minutes now remain. Nancy a spinning kick right there. Reduction! And an elbow putting Kagetsu back down. Nancy, oh god, that's a steel chair in him. Watch it! Nancy Cradle with the steel chair in his hand! Over and over and over again. June Cradle now trying to get on top of Nancy Cradle. Sending her over the top rope to the outside of the ring. June Cradle, what's she thinking? Did a... apron down to the outside of the ring. June Cradle trying to stop on either, but Nancy coming back, taking June Cradle back. Shooting star! Now Kagetsu going after June. Striking away on the Chaos Women's Champion. 3 minutes and 55 seconds remain in the windmill match. June Cradle still has the point. Somebody's got him hitting somebody, so June Cradle does not have the point. Preferably Kagetsu hitting one of the two to take the point for himself. Boom!
right after him. Nancy from behind. Cable trying to strike to get to Nancy with the field of glow. Submission on the outside of the ring. Letting it go to Nancy Cuervo. Deciding against it. And June Cuervo getting back to her feet. Nancy wants to take down her sister instead. Taking June back into the ring. June Cuervo in a dire situation. Now look at Nancy. Here we go. This is exactly what Nancy Cuervo wants. On a swing board. Drop kick. Take down June. Swing board drop kick. Now Nancy has an opportunity right now to even the door. Looping palm strike. Cover by Nancy, cover one, cover two, to get to kick in there time, Nancy Cuervo now has the point. It is 1-0-0 for Nancy Cuervo. The window has been passed on to Nancy, oh, there! If this timer ends, Nancy will win. 2 minutes and 45 seconds to get to steer to Cuervo in half. And now Kagetsu trying to take the lead for herself. And Kagetsu drop to June. Count one. Count two. Kagetsu takes the lead again. 1-0-0. Kagetsu. 2.5 minutes remaining. June Cuervo trying to fight back and get the win back for herself. Kagetsu fighting back to right hand. Striking away. June Cuervo going back. Looking for the blue thunderbomb. Neil and Joe break the counter by Kagetsu. Now the strike. From the Prime Minister. The final block. Chokehold picked out. June Cuervo now. Here's Nancy out of nowhere. Stumbling through. Got by Kagetsu. But Kagetsu not allowing Nancy to get any. Look at this combination. Not allowing any sort of offense to come through from Nancy. Trying to strike Nancy. Head back with the kick down. Roundhouse right into the corner. Trying to fight back again. It's Kagetsu this time. Kagetsu off. To go like drop kick blocked by Nancy Cuervo. 1 minute and 50 seconds remain. Nancy back. Oh, Jesus. Straight out straight into the mat. Face first to Kagetsu. Cuervo. Oh, God. Roundhouse takes out Nancy. And also trying to take out Kagetsu at the same time. Oh, ankle stops in the back of the ankle. Oh, Kagetsu go like drop kick. Nancy countering back the other way. 1.5 minutes remain in this windmill match. Roundhouse might suplex from Nancy Cuervo. Yet to currently have the lead. She will win this match. It just the time will go down to zero. Nancy Cuervo on the swing board, trying to take out Kagetsu sneakily, but Kagetsu not allowing that to happen. Striking Nancy Cuervo over and over again with all the runs with third. Trying to run through, take down Nancy with beautiful aggression. And now with Kagetsu going back the other way herself, kicking and striking away. Kagetsu, oh! Choke playing the June. Now Kagetsu headed up to the top rope, 1 minute on the clock, only 1 minute to survive! An elbow drop from the very, very top rope. Kagetsu to the outside of the ring, 50 seconds remain. This match coming to a close. Chair in hand, Kagetsu striking away! Over and over and over again on the June Cuervo, Chaos on the champion struggling hard. Kagetsu though, sees Nancy getting up on the outside of the ring, 35 seconds remain, Kagetsu striking Nancy. Oh, flying forearm, take down Cuervo. Nancy on the outside, struck down by Kagetsu. And now Kagetsu with 25 seconds on the clock. Kagetsu drop to Nancy Cuervo. Putting her out for the rest of this match. Now it's just down to June and Kagetsu. June Cuervo now striking away and Kagetsu. Back elbow. Another back elbow. And another one. 7 seconds, oh no, oh no! Kamakoye, 3, 2, 1! Kagetsu will take the win! The Kamakoye can enter, but the clock ran out! The windmill match will go to Kagetsu! That's an interesting match type for you, I bet you haven't seen that one before, eh? Beautiful win by Kagetsu, pretty dominant that entire match, and she would have kicked out of here, alright? If you know Kagetsu, she kicked out of the Tombstone Piledriver. Only two people have kicked. She would have kicked out of one Kamakoye. Come on, y'all. If there's any controversy over this, you're going to get yelled at because you're an idiot. Kagetsu with the victory here tonight. Undeniably. No argument. Here comes Manic and Ivy, the Intergalactic Champion, beating AJ Lee and Backblade in a huge match for the ages. And tonight on Chaos, it's something to say.
Oh, God! Taunting the Archangel, but look at it! Archangel trying to make her pay! They're going to tombstone, but no, Madison Ivy getting out of it, just the tomb, and Ivy gonna go back the other way! Tombstone, lung blower! My God! Ivy standing tall over the Archangel! Talk trash all you want, she's got the better of her!
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the Heavyweight Championship.
You heard it here. Decided earlier tonight, tonight's main event is a Chaos Heavyweight Championship match between Marco Zamora and Bond Jacob. Earlier tonight, it was Bond Jacobs and Marco Zamora setting up a match in the main event for the Chaos Heavyweight Championship. The only condition Marco would have accepted the match for Bond Jacobs to try and get his hands on him and beat him in a fair and square match, unlike what happened at Fastlane because of Marco Zamora's role. You know how that goes. Referee better be paying close attention here tonight. But, yeah, Marco Zamora's one condition was to make it for the championship, and Bond Jacobs accepted. And this is how we're going to end up tonight, a Chaos Heavyweight Championship matchup. And you got to remember, Bron Jacobs has an opportunity to lose the title because Marco Zamora not only is a better and better superstar by each week that passes. I mean, he is getting better, right? And he also has to watch out for the low blow that Marco can always throw out of nowhere. But on the other hand, Marco Zamora is always Mr. Money in the Bank still. He could cash it in on the Chaos Heavyweight Championship if he truly wanted to. It's always an opportunity, but for sure that Marco Zamora is eventually going to do that. I mean, and look, if Marco wins here tonight, then not only will he have the Heavyweight Championship, but he'll also be Mr. Money in the Bank. He has a chance to win in whatever other title he wants. I assume one of the World Championships, because it's the Chaos Championship held by Rafael Draco, which would be a silly decision, but it's an option. And then there's always the Universal title held by Paul Mysterio, who seems to have a little bit more history with. So both ones are very, very option. Every opportunity taken by Marco Zamora seems to be a good one. He never lets one of his recent matches go to waste, especially winning close Battle Royale for 2 years. Bond Jacobs ready to go. The monster has arrived on Chaos. Trying to defend his championship successfully against his biggest rival at the moment. All Bond Jacobs wants is to get Marco off his back and away from his system, but that seems to be a lot more than just beating him here tonight if he does. It's more of a backstage thing, more of a behind-the-scenes kind of rivalry, too. There's a lot more to this that I personally don't know myself. Justice and the epitome of justice has been mentioned for a few times, but it's never really been seen on screen other than the occasional dark matches. Well, Madison Ivy and the Archangel team, but Madison wasn't exactly a full-time member of the epitome of justice. He was like an honorary member or something? You know, I don't know. It's a complicated situation, right? The epitome of darkness seems to be growing stronger and stronger throughout the week's following, and it seems like Bond Jacobs is having more and more of a tough time getting rid of Marco Zamora. Marco is getting better, he's learning strategies, and it's dangerous for Bond Jacobs, but of course he is the monster. He is still one of the best superstars in the entire roster, and I don't have a doubt in my mind that he has a high chance of walking out still to champion here tonight, no matter how good Marco has become.
Introducing the challenger, from Austin, Texas, weighing in at 210 pounds, Marco! And introducing the champion, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 307 pounds, he is the heavyweight champion!
Heavyweight championship on the line. Who is going to walk out tonight with this title? It's an opportunity for both sides, and it's a chance to be a new champion here tonight. I wouldn't say it all goes well. I wouldn't want Marco to win, but you get my point, right? We'll find out. Here we go, referee. Ring that bell. We are underway.
Vaughn, Jacob, Hector, and Mark of the War has resulted in only success for Vaughn other than the recent time at Fastlane especially. Jacob landing an uppercut. Fastlane was the moment Vaughn Jacob proved to be vulnerable. Low blow or not, Marco hit a low blow on the Vaughn Jacob and the referee was out of the ring. But he hit one zigzag kick out. Two zigzag kick out. But zigzag number three, Vaughn Jacob could not kick out of. Mark of the War fell. Fell short to Vaughn Jacob, who has been proving to be incredible at the recent. Mark of the Mark slamming a head down in the mat, looking for his own control of his offense. Mark stomping a drop kick. Vaughn Jacob moves out of the way from behind now, coming through, looking for the upper kick. Mark of the Mark counter, ready to the corner. Look at a strut, flip over into a knee. That's a big power from someone like Mark of the Mark, who has improved immensely. At the debut, looking for the elbow drop, not quite. Mark of the Mark trying to grab Vaughn, not going to happen. Mark of the Mark rolled out of the way, though. Oh, Marco connecting with a drop kick. Right hand, and Vaughn Jacob back the other way with a forearm. Uppercut, Marco not falling to the mat. Going to take a little bit more, looking for another one. It's Marco fighting back on his own turn. The Mora, face buster into the mat. Marco quick cover on the heavyweight champion. Count of one. Kick out by Vaughn. Of course, it's going to take a lot more, but Marco knows the wear down strategy better than a lot more of most of these people on this roster. He's one of the best at doing it. Hangman neckbreaker takes out Vaughn Jacobs. Marco Vaughn now looking to remain in control. What's the next plan for him? Jacobs stuck back to his feet. Marco grabbing Vaughn and slamming him down. Then a man, an arm breaker, beautifully done, but Vaughn Jacobs moving out of the way. Here's Marco fighting back anyway. Zamora, now drop kick to the knee. Vaughn doesn't fall. Vaughn Jacobs now striking away. Right hand, Marco dodges back out to Zamora. A striking game between the two. Who is going to win the striking game? Who is going to go down first? Marco takes him into the corner. Vaughn Jacobs fighting back himself. Vaughn Jacobs running through the punt. Uppercut to Marco falls. Vaughn Jacobs getting the better of the striking game. Kind of a given though. Vaughn Jacobs with his power strength and his amazing ability to strike his opponent that quick speed to fight his thigh really comes as a gift. Jacobs a right, a left, a right, a combination going for four. And a clothesline right across the head. Marco Zamora goes down to the mat. Cross body and a body splash from the corner. Now Vaughn Jacobs back into the ground and pound on Marco Zamora. All Braun wants to do is inflict pain on Marco, especially with recently of what he's been talking about with his sister. Braun wants to protect his sister at all costs and wants to protect his championship. And he's going to do that by taking the hand of Marco Zamora for good. Trying to get rid of the threat as quickly as possible. Fisherman Buster from the mat. Jacobs has Marco up again. The power from the heavyweight champion. Power slam straight down into the mat. They're going to grab him again, but it's Marco fighting back. Zamora now with the opportunity. Elbow drop number two. Zamora, elbow drop number three. Jacobs crawling down to the floor again. Stuck in a bad place. Still grounded. Marco to a very, very top rope counter to get him on his feet. It's getting really bad, looking for a cross body, but it's Vaughn Jacobs who catches him in midair. Into a backbreaker, second backbreaker, and throwing him across the ring. Vaughn Jacobs remained tall. Vaughn Jacobs catching him out of midair, making him pay. One of the specialties of Vaughn Jacobs' insanely powerful moveset that he had going for him. One of the best this company has ever seen. Vaughn Jacobs taking him to the other side. Marco Zamora counters. Put clothesline into the corner. Vaughn Jacobs still in control. Into a neck snap. Marco Zamora caught in a real bad spot. And Vaughn Jacobs maybe looking to put this thing to an end sooner than later. Jacobs grabbing Zamora, taking him to the opposite side corner. Vaughn grabbing Zamora, bouncing him off the top. Rock him over here. Belly to belly. This is looking like a squash match. And it might just be maybe Vaughn Jacobs has found a true mojo against somebody like Marco Zamora. Because right now it seems to not even be a question of who's about to win this match until Marco Zamora does find his fight back at least a little bit. Zamora right, but Vaughn Jacobs again, undeniably putting that offense to work. Marco cannot find a way out of this situation he put into. Swinging him around, backbreaker, cutting him down to the mat, a final cut straight floor. flooring Gamora, and now put it on the back up to a three after another ground and strike. David taking him into the corner with Reed. Vaughn putting, oh god. Yep, this is why you have to watch out if you Marco. Die doesn't matter! Pounded him across the ring, and now it's Braun Jacobs' match to take. Jacobs with Gamora, back to his seat. Uranagi to the floor! And the squash match continues. This is looking like a bad ending for Gamora. Braun Jacobs taking him back into the corner and placing him on the top rope. Braun Jacobs, undeniable dominance in this matchup. Braun got Marco. Fallaway slam! From the very top rope! This is complete dominance. Keller and now bring it on. Here's Jacobs now. Looking for the colossal end, but Marco counted the Gamora clothesline. Braun Jacobs swaps him away. One colossal end attempt. Marco able to avoid it at the last second. Dropkick, Braun thrown off falling. Another dropkick. Marco finally gets Braun Jacobs down to the mat. A huge moment for Gamora. Trying to finally get his offense back very late into this match. This main event seeing Marco struggle big time against Jacobs. Benny Yamanagi. That might put him to the floor for good. Marco finding a little bit of his mojo now, and Braun Jacobs in a bad place. Gamora taking him into the corner. Marco punching the midsection in a right hand. Jumping away over and over again in the corner. Marco Gamora finally getting back into this thing. Braun Jacobs dominated most of the match, but he grabs him by the leg and swings him down to the mat with the dragon screw. Marco counters again the right hand. Jacobs counters. Jacobs went up with a touch in the midsection. Another tough strike. A right hand. It's Marco countering with the right of his own. Marco Gamora trying to grab him. It's Braun Jacobs countering. Looking for a clothesline. It's Marco countering. Back elbow. Gamora from behind. Trying to grab Braun Jacobs. Big dive. Big glance with the big dive. No. No. Cover. By Marco Gamora. But Braun Jacobs kicked out of two. You have to be extremely careful. Marco Gamora with a zigzag, and that might be an opportunity for him to win this thing if he hits another one. Jacobs just got caught completely off guard. Marco Gamora! Jumping DDT! Did you see the power on that one? Gamora has Braun Jacobs now in a cold Russian leg sweep. Braun Jacobs falling to the mat. Marco Gamora grabbed by Braun. Braun goes back to the ring without Marco to counter. Marco on right. Braun Jacobs takes him into the corner anyway. Braun Jacobs trying to grab him. Marco moves out of the way. Jacobs almost got caught with a dropkick, but here he is! Throwing him across the ring. Jacobs got him up, but no, Marco counters again. Another counter by Gamora. He's never won a championship in his career. To this point, this would be his fourth ever title win, and it would be against Braun Jacobs. But Jacobs, not looking to make that come true. Uranagi to Marco. And I think this is the main opportunity that Braun Jacobs has truly been waiting for. Jacobs looking to put that thing to a phenomenal finish. Braun Jacobs with Marco out. Looking for the colossal end. But Marco counters again. Taking him out with a clothesline off a kneeling jawbreaker. Marco avoiding defeat again. If Braun Jacobs hit that colossal end, man, it is over. It is absolutely over. Same thing if he hits the colossal knee. Either way, Braun Jacobs will fall. Oh, keeping Marco the more of a fall, but Marco with a neckbreaker, seemingly avoiding that for now. Marco Gamora falling down with an elbow drop to the midsection. Second elbow drop, trying to keep him grounded for as long as possible. Three hard elbow drop to Braun Jacobs' chest. Marco now headed to the top, maybe looking for one for the very top. Body slash instead. Marco telling him that it's his time to shine. It's his time to become a champion. Off the ropes with speed, grabbing him into a face thruster. Marco now from behind, turns it into a Russian leg sweep of a combination of Braun Jacobs. Marco Gamora fired up and ready to go. Off the ropes with speed, double that hand on Braun Jacobs, right to the midsection. This has been Marco's main priority, the midsection of Braun Jacobs, and it seems to be paying off. Until the right hand is countered by Braun, right hand countered by Marco, right hand countered by Braun, driving away in the face. Marco counters with a gut kick to the midsection. Braun counters in the forearm across the face. Marco ducks under with the right. Gamora right-handed with on a combination, getting a battle of the striking against Braun Jacobs. Gamora, now punching him down in the corner. 3, 4, 5. 10 hard strikes in the corner. Jacobs is in trouble. The championship in jeopardy. We made the new champion here tonight. He might not even have to cash in the Money in the Bank contract. Marco's got him up the Tower of Doom. Cover by Marco Zamora for the championship. Braun Jacob kicked out at 2. It's not over yet though. Marco Zamora with another signature move. He can't be looking for that finisher at any time. Tower ends up bringing on from behind. Marco looking for the dig deck. Braun Jacob. Yeah, trying to keep him grounded. Marco rolling out of the way. Drop kick out of nowhere. Kicked out Braun Jacob. Jacob rolls out of the way. A right hand. Marco counters to the right. Marco with the right of the toe. Braun Jacob trying to go again. A right hand. Counter by Marco. Marco right counter by Braun. Drop down the way. Marco with the right of his own. Counter by Braun. Jacob. 3, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6,
with the win! What a finish for Fargo! Will not be successful in his championship match! Brian Jacob, still the Chaos Heavyweight Champion, and what a phenomenal finish! No pun intended.
Here is your winner, and still heavyweight champion.
And that is how you do a main event. Braun Jacobs still your champion. Marco Amora. Well, that is low blow. Cannot beat Braun Jacobs, and I think that has been true already. Even before this match, but I think it's solidified for everybody else who didn't believe. Braun Jacobs still the champion. Thank you for stopping by. We will see you next week on Velocity.